known as Viki. Have you all used Viki?
Yeah.
You use Viki? Who use Viki? Okay. Viki is not, we are not inserting the Viki, you click add Viki. Okay. So this is very good for all of you if you all want to write, ask the student to improve their writing skill. Okay. So you want them to teach, learn how to write, right? Creative writing skill. So you make a group of 4 students, you assign them a Viki. You click on the Viki, add. Can you add 4 of them to the class? Can you enroll 4 of our friends? Yeah. Our colleagues, can you add our colleagues to my class? Okay, I'll show you how the Viki actually works. You can just assign 4 of them to the class. Just add them to the class. Just randomly. Just for the introduction. I want to show them how to use Viki. So you can assign. Usually we had Chorak for the PDF in for the one, right?
That's
so
right.
When we have our PPST, sorry, when we make our PPST PHP page, we have to assign that, we have to make a new PHP for this.
Oh yeah.
So we have to reassign.
You mean the statistic?
Yeah.
Ah, yeah.
We have to reassign or we do manual because it's only few of us can do manual once and three.
Mm.
For now they can add as 5, right?
Yeah. I need to ask a woman.
Only 4, I think should be okay. 4 should be okay. Adam, sit down. Okay, so some of you all are in my class, you all can identify who you all are. And then you enroll yourself. Sit down, enroll. Okay, now we go back to that page again, demo PTSD. And I want to teach you all writing skills. So add an activity or resource, and then you add the Viki. Viki. Okay, add Viki. Okay, now the Viki will be open. Did you all get a message saying you are enrolled in the course? Email? You can check your Smart Tree system. You check your Smart Tree and see whether you are enrolled in my course. In my course. It's called Enroll. Just check. Just check your Smart Tree. You can check there. My courses. It's called My Courses. Are you all enrolled in this course?
Yes, sir.
Who is enrolled? Some of you. Cool. You can enroll, right? Okay. So now I'm going to pick, just call a Viki, collaborative Viki. Share your ideas here. Display description on the course page. And then collaborative wiki. First page name is just called introduction. Cannot connect the server. Wait for a while. Okay, format Godam, format. Okay, default format, common module setting. Okay, no groups, none, moving none, restrict access, none. And then keep everything open. Okay, go. Just keep everything open. Just keep open. Okay. Now this is a Viki which I am creating for my class. you all are four of you all are enrolled in the class. Okay? It's waiting for the server to come. Okay, so go down. It's called collaborative wiki. Now, okay, so students can manually, if you want a student to involve in the wiki, you just click here. Student, activity has completed when condition are met. So only when the student does the actual work, you will give the mark. Don't give them the freedom to, okay? So student must do this activity to complete it, okay. As expected completion on put 3rd December 2019. So you give them deadline. Maybe if you put in a rubric, if they don't complete by certain date, you will get maybe 5% mark. So you can tags, you can add tag, post completion, no selection, okay, so done. Open activity completion. Click here, do nothing, just go down. Good. Okay, save and display. Can you all see this on your course? After I save it, wait, it's saving. Okay, go to the introduction. Okay, the main page. Okay, so we go back to your introduction. Okay, now all of you who have enrolled in this class, you can click and see if you can see. Can you see it? Can you write something on it? Can you just write, click, write. Just click and write anything. Click, write, submit. Anything, just put some single sentence.
Which
Great lah.
Okay.
Saya dong boleh test kan?
Okay. Now see, all of you all are editing it right, but when I see the comments. Okay, and then you click history. Okay, now see what's happening. Look at what the teacher can see. If somebody says, only I do, everyone did the work and I'm also contributing, right? But I did not contribute anything, the evidence is there, Pilar, and the time. You know who the person is. When you send the assignment, usually six students, one will do all the work, two will do the work, all the assignment. Just following Pilar. So this one you can see the comment well done, okay? So you can see the version 6, and this is telling you the version, okay? Okay, I'll tell you how we use. So you tell the first student to write a story, Okay, the second student edit the story. You can assign them roles. So this is actually enabling them to achieve their cognitive level, which is higher, which is you can go up to the domain where you do the evaluation. You can reach evaluation domain with this because they can evaluate their peers' work. Okay? So here you can say, ask the student to write a sentence in, paraphrase a description in English. So already we reach cognitive level 3. Okay? You ask the second student in the group to review the paraphrase, so to select between two definitions and come out with the third. Already you reach synthesis and already you reach the, so you can prove to your evaluator for the MKF5, you already achieved the domain, cognitive domain. So you can use this very well for Wiki. Wiki is a very good tool for cognition, to evaluate cognition. Okay, so that's it. So you can compare, click, you click on the compare select, right? So you can compare, you click on all, select all. So you can compare and you can see the thing, so you can see all the changes. Okay, so Wiki is a good tool for project collaboration.